Welcome back to Bard's Tale 3. This is T. Rodman. I'm actually talking over the game instead of talking while playing the game this time. This is a recording. I recorded a little earlier, and I'm running at 2x speed. The first thing about this recording is that I was trying out different mechanisms to make small files because I wanted to make a really long recording, because I wanted to do a lot of leveling up. So there's actually a gap where I tried to use Vice's built-in recording and it lost the data, so it's not very obvious, but just letting you know. So what I'm doing is I'm going down to level 3 of Unterbrede again. Here I'm just fighting stuff off to get there. And the goal is to use my new spells, basically Mind Blade. Or maybe I haven't gotten them yet. It's so confusing going back and forth. I'm pretty sure. Okay, so yeah, the leveling up is in the middle of this session. But anyway, so it's to get Mind Blade and then continue to use it to reach a point where I can potentially beat Brilhasty, who is, of course, the boss of this first dungeon. Oh, and there's going to be a lot of dead audio time in this, at least for my speaking, so I thought I'd add in a little background music. I chose Underclocked Remix by Eric Skiff, and there's a link to it down in the description below. Here I managed to pick up a sorcerer's staff. Briefly thought this was the kind of staff that it halves your spell costs, but that's in Bard's Tale 1, they like swapped what they mean. And I actually haven't even figured out what the sorcerer's staff does yet. I gave it to the right person, identified it, I tried to use it out of combat. I never got around to trying to use it in combat yet. That'll be for later. Thank you. You can see my higher levels there helped out by allowing me to disbelieve an enemy without using a special disbelief spell. I'm hoping that the cuts can be more often in the future. This fight has a pretty close call where the restoration spell lands just in time. I was sweating it for a bit there. Towards the end of this fight, I started to wonder whether it was worth my time having done it at all. It sure took a while. There's a thief critting a ranged spellcaster, sort of what she's for. And again. That was a bone acolyte. I'd put up a poster of Elena and be like, take this woman out. Thank you. Around this point, I'd finished doing hitting all of the known combat spots on one floor, and I thought I had enough experience to level up. Also, I really was tired of Grisnak being old, so I figured it was time to go take care of all of that. This is actually the emulator in warp mode, which is why it's so fast. If you look carefully, a couple of fighters went up a level, although I didn't care too much about that. And my mages went up a level, but they were, if I remember correctly, around 550 experience short of the critical level where I gained spells. So I wandered around town and killed stuff just to tick me over. It's sort of annoying how the game insists on throwing things like leather armor at you when you're level 14 and are wearing mithril or adamant plate. A price, I guess, I have to bear. Entering the view board again at normal speed. You can give Griselda levels up and Elendor levels up. Like, you've trained them on their new spells. And then go outside and I look through the spell list to give a chance to talk about them. So there are two new spells at this point. One of them is Disrupt Illusion, which is a handy spell for increasing the chance to ignore illusions. The other one is Mind Blade. Disrupt Illusion is nice, Mind Blade is great. Mind Blade does probably about as much damage as my strongest spell so far, and it applies that damage to every enemy in the combat. Well, okay, every enemy up to something like 60 feet. I can actually check. I haven't actually been bringing the manual up on screen because it is entirely, you know, like web browsers are giant and it just doesn't integrate with the recording very well, but if you were actually playing this game the first time, I think you would consult the manual a lot. So, for example, Mind Blade here, I think it's wrong, actually. It's listed as only hitting things 30 feet away. There are a number of errors in manuals on both Bardstale 2 and 3 with the distance, but it certainly doesn't go more than 50 feet, so really far things far away don't get hit by it, but everything up in your face does. And speaking of manuals, here's where I look up the Hawk Blade. I'm wondering how good is it? And I discover it's not that good. It's okay, it's as good as Dayblades. But I already have Dayblades, and Dayblades do more. So, teleporting back down to the dungeon, I I continue to kill everything I see, although this time I have some new weapons. There's a fight with four winged demons, which are pretty scary. So everyone attacks the winged demons and try out a new mind blade with a restoration effect. We get pretty hurt. I slow it down so I can see what's going on. But by the time the first round's over, I think most of the winged demons are already dead. And yeah, everything but two magic eaters was dead after the first round. I was pretty stoked about that. Blade is kind of a one-size-fits-all spell. Four different huge slats? Well, whatever. Mind Blade. I was pretty excited about this fight. Seven Nefast, I was thinking, oh, they're going to summon more Nefast. And then they'll summon more Nefast. And I don't ever have to stop them from doing that. I can just keep killing them. So, Mind Blade applied. You know, doesn't kill them off. They have a lot of hit points. I'll just, you know, keep casting the Mind Blade and eventually they'll fall over. But by then, they'll be more Nefast. It was kind of a good idea, but they let me down by just dying too quickly. Look at that, killing it, you know. They don't make Nefast like they used to. Thank you. I was pretty excited about this piece of loot. Adamantite plate is just the next step on the development of my characters. I gave it to Grisnok partly because I'm starting to think about Lady Oakshield as someone who's gonna go. I got another caster, and somehow Grisnok just appeals to me more. And I've got a love affair with monks. Hop Blossom's gonna stay. So, Lady Okashi will be moving away, but I do find for now, I find another adamantite plate for her later in this adventure.
Thank you.
This is the point where I have finished killing everything on the level. So what to do? Go down the floor, go back up the floor, walk out, kill them all again. Oops, my bard song fell off and I got into an encounter with hand-to-hand enemies due to bad status effects. I'll just cast invisibility twice. There are 9 is 22 armor class, try hitting me this time. Thank you. And now for the level ups. Everyone's finally got to level 14, except for the sorcerers, who at least have hit their next level. I think it's like 10. $15,000 more to go for the next milestone. Yep, 10 it is. 11 isn't so far away, but 13 is quite a ways. Oof.